Hello all, welcome everyone. I am Seth Sri Gautami, studying degree second year MPCS in TTWRDC Women Kottagudem. I am going to discuss about the stack and queue in data structures. I will begin with the introduction of data structures and briefly explain about the stack and queue, like representation, operations and applications. Data structure affects the design and both structural and functional aspects of a program. We all know a program is equal to algorithm plus data structure. For this, we can easily understand how data structures are important in computer language. Okay? A data structure is a data organization, management and storage format that able to efficient access and modify them. More preciously, a data structure is a collection of data values. And we all know, algorithm is a step-by-step process to solve a particular function. Okay, and we have to know what is data and what is data structure. Data is a collection of raw facts, and data structure is a representation of the logical relationship existing between individual elements of the data. Classification of data structures. There are two major classifications in data structures. There are primitive data structures and non-primitive data structures. Here we have clear chart about the data structures. Think carefully and observe and keep in your mind. Primitive data structure. Data structures that are directly operated upon the machine level instructions are known as primitive data structures. The primitive data structures are primitive data types. The int, char, float, double and pointers are the primitive structures that can hold a single value. The mostly commonly used operations on the data structures are broadly categorized into create, selection, updating, destroy. Okay, create. We can create and we can select and we can updating and we can remove the elements. Coming to the non-primitive data structures, the data structures that are derived from the primitive data structures are called non-primitive data structures. Non-primitive data structure is divided into two types. Linear data structures, non-linear data structures. The arrangement of data in a sequential manner is known as linear data structure, and it has homogeneous elements. Some commonly used linear data structures are stack, queue, and linked list. And coming to the non-linear data structures, a non-linear data structure is a data structure in which data items is connected to several other data items. The data items are not arranged in a sequential order, and the different non-linear data structures are trees and graphs. The most commonly used operations on data structure are broadly categorized into searching, sorting, insertion, updation, and deletion. Searching. We can search for any element in a data structure. Sorting. We can sort the elements of a data structure either in ascending order or descending order. Insertion. We can also insert the new elements in a data structure. Updation. We can also update the element, like we can replace the element with another element. Deletion. We can also perform the delete operation to remove the element from the data structure. Difference between them. Okay, what is the difference between primitive data structure and non-primitive data structure? A primitive data structure is generally a basic structure that is usually built into the language, such as an integer, a float. A non-primitive data structure is built out of primitive data structures linked together in meaningful ways, such as a linked list, binary search tree, AVL trees, graph. One dimensional array. Before going to learn about the one dimensional array, we have to know what is an array and how many types in array. Yes?
Yes.
An arrangement of objects, pictures or numbers in rows and columns is called an array. Arrays are useful representation of multiplication aspects. There are three types in arrays: one-dimensional array, two-dimensional array, and multi-dimensional array. Here, one-dimensional array. An array with only one row or column is called one-dimensional array. It is finite collection of n number of elements of same data type. Okay, syntax. It is very important. Syntax is data type, array name, and size. Data type. What is the data type? Okay, we all know there are many data types, you know, int, char, float, these are all the data types. And array name. Array name, it have to be identify the array. And size, the maximum number of elements that the array can hold. Okay, let's say one example. Data type int. Array name student. Size 24. Int student 24. Okay, is it clear? Simply declaration of array int array del, where int specify the data type or type of elements array stored. Array is the name of array and the number of specified inside the square bracket is the number of elements an array can store. This is also called size or length of array. Represent a linear array in memory. The elements of linear array are stored in a consequent memory location. It is shown like this. Okay, by seeing this we easily understand. Next, yes. Array type. We already discussed single dimensional array or one dimensional array. Two, that means array with one subscript. Two dimensional array. Array with two subscripts, rows and columns, and multi-dimensional array, array with multiple subscripts. Coming to the two-dimensional array, a two-dimensional array is a collection of elements and each element is identified by a pair of subscripts. The elements are stored in continuous memory location. The elements of two-dimensional array as rows and columns. By seeing the example, we can easily understand. And the number of rows and columns in a matrix is called as the order of the matrix and denoted as m into n. The number of elements can be obtained by multiplying number of rows and number of columns. Representation of two-dimensional array. A is the array of order m into n. To store m into n number of elements, we need m into n memory location. The elements should be in contiguous memory location. There are two methods, row measure method, column measure method. We can give row measure or column measure. Advantages of array. It is used to represent multiple data items of same type of using single name. It can be used to implement other data structures like linked lists, stacks, queues, trees, graphs, etc. Two-dimensional arrays are used to represent matrices. Many databases include one-dimensional arrays whose elements are records. Okay, we also have disadvantages also. Disadvantages of array. We must know in advance an array. We already know the syntax of array. What is that? Data structure, data type, array name and size. We have to declare the size first itself. For that reason, we may get some problems. Array is static structure. It means that array is of fixed size, The memory which is allocated to array cannot be increased or decreased. It is fixed. We cannot increase and we cannot decrease. Array is fixed size. The elements of array are sorted in consecutive memory locations. So insertion and deletion are very difficult and time consuming. So these are the disadvantages of array. Stack. Yes. It's a very important topic. Stack is a linear data structure which follows a particular order in which the operations are performed. Insertion of element into the stack is push and deletion of element from the stack is called pop. These are very important. Push, pop. We are adding or inserting element means push. Deleting or removing from the stack is pop. The order may be LIFO. LIFO means last in, first out. Or FIRO means first in, last out. Okay, you may get here some confusion. What is first in, last out, last in, first out? Okay, nothing. Okay, if you place a coin, one by one coin, if first place coin will come last, and last place coin will come first. Okay, so like that only. And representation of stack in memory. The stack can be implemented into two ways, using array and using pointer. Static implementation or dynamic implementation. Dynamic means at runtime. Operation on stack. Stack function. It creates a new stack. This is empty. It needs no parameters and returns an empty stack. And push function. It adds a new item to the top of the stack. We already learned that what is push, adding element to the stack. Yes. And pop function. What is pop? Deleting. So it removes the top item from the stack. And peek function. It returns the top item from the stack but does not remove it. Is empty function. It tests whether the stack is empty or not. Size function. It returns the number of items on the stack. How many elements in the stack? Okay. Stack condition. Depending on implementation, may be necessary to check if stack is full. Attempt to add items to a full stack is an overflow error. If there is no space in stack, how can we add into the stack? So it gives error. Like that only, important to know if stack is empty. Attempt to remove an item from an empty stack is an underflow error. Okay, there is no elements in the stack. How can we remove the elements in the stack? Yes? So it gives some error. So we have to know if a stack is empty or full. Okay? Push operation. The process of adding one element or item to the stack is represented by the operation called as the push. Adding element is push. Removing element is pop. We all had learned. Yes? Yes. Okay, here there is an empty stack. So we can add. So we can push an element. Here we are pushing the element A. Second, B. Enter C. There is no space and stack is filled. So we didn't push any other elements into the stack. If we want to push the element, means it gives the error. Okay? And next, pop operation. Pop means deletion. The process of deleting one element or item from the stack is represent pop. Okay, here A, B, C elements are there. We have to pop the C. Next B, next A, next it's an empty stack. So we didn't and we can't pop any element from this stack. So if you want to pop means it gives the error. Okay? Applications of stack. Runtime memory management, quick sort to solve tower of hang, conversion of decimal numbers to binary. These all are the applications of stack. Next, important topic is queue. queue is an ordered collection of items where an item is inserted at one end called the array and an existing item is removed at the other end called the frame. Queue is also called as FIFO list, that means first in, first out. In the queue, only two operations are allowed, enqueue and dequeue. Enqueue means to insert an item into back of the queue. Dequeue means removing the frame item. The people standing in a railway reservation row are an example of queue. The queue can be implemented into two ways, using array static implementation, using pointer dynamic implementation. I already said dynamic implementation means at runtime, okay? And types of queues. Queues can be of four types: simple queue, circular queue, periodic queue, dequeue, double-ended queue, okay? Simple queue. In simple queue, insertion occurs at the race end of the list and deletion occurs at the front end of the list. Circular queue. A circular queue is a queue in which all nodes are treated as circular such that the last node follows the first node. Periodic queue. A periodic queue is a queue that contains items that have some present priority. An element can be inserted or removed from any position depending upon some priority. Dequeue. It is a queue in which insertion and deletion takes place at the both ends. Okay? Listen carefully. Insertion and deletion takes place at the both ends. Okay? Operation on queue. Queue function. It creates a new queue that is empty. Enqueue function. It adds a new item to the RAID of the queue. Dequeue. It removes the front item from the queue. IsEmpty function. It tests to see whether the queue is empty. Size function. It returns the number of items in the queue. Application of queue. Simultation, printer, server, routine. Various application software is also based on queue data structures. And there are some daily life examples in queue also, like a ticket line, an escalator. Okay, by seeing these examples, you can easily understand queue. I hope you understand stack and queue. Okay, before closing the session, I want to give a feedback. Stack and queue are two classes of access limited, mutable, unbounded sequences. Coming to the stack is one of the most important data structure in computer science. Elements can be added to or removed from a stack at only one end. Since we view this end as the top of the stack, we use the term push for add and the term pop for remove. Notice that the element popped from a stack is always the last one pushed onto it. Therefore, a stack is referred to as a last in, first out list. Coming to the queue, elements can be added only at one end, the RAID. Elements can be removed only at the other end, the frame. We call adding to a queue enqueuing and removing from a queue dequeuing. A queue is referred to as a first in, first out. I hope you all understand, and thank you.